Michael Dyson.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
What a night here tonight.
Amen.
Reverend Dr. Robert Smith, who began this program with that gut bucket gospel glory, taking us back old school with his compressed chaos and his edifying cool. Then we had, of course, Audrey Du Bois Harris, who elevated us to operatic heights. That soprano ceiling was pierced with her poignant performance of black genius with the embrace of European classical form, baptizing it in Negro style. And then, of course, the Williams brothers, taking it back to Mississippi, taking it back to where the roots are, to the deep mud and the delta from which we emerged, tracing that great black migration up the highway from Mississippi, going toward Chicago, and others from Georgia and the like, going toward Detroit. We know about Mississippi-Detroit connections. Then, of course, the great Vanessa Bell Armstrong, a volcanic vocalist who embodies the strict genius of Detroit, tethered to the Pentecostal fury of a grand expression of the gospel. And what can we say about Lorinda Clark Cole? Preacher as gospel evangelist, with that kind of homiletical fury and that beautiful, powerful voice telling the truth about our common experience as Christians. And then, of course, we will be feated by none other than the great Reverend Shirley Caesar. Now, that ain't nothing but unadulterated, unadorned gospel glory. And we know she's going to take us to yet another step. But I must say to you, I am glad to be here tonight. Of course, with that beginning prayer by the Reverend Marcia Dyson.
Yes.
But I'm so honored to be here with the Queen. The Queen. The Queen of Soul. Aretha Franklin had a freakish precociousness in this church where she was birthed in her father's majestic rhetorical womb. That great expression of black gospel genius. It wasn't just about the gravy. We know about the gravy. But it was also about the intellectual and academic substance. Before he thrilled you like Dr. Smith, he gave you something to think about. He gave you something to meditate upon. He gave you something to reflect on. Because all gravy can do is make the meat that produced it better. But gravy without meat is futile, but meat with gravy is satisfying and edifying. And Dr. C.L. Franklin gave us the best of that Mississippi meets Detroit genius. He would ask questions in the midst of his rhetorical fury and his homiletical creativity and his hermeneutical depth. And he gave to us the best of who we are as a people. And out of that womb at 12 and 13 and 14 years old, a young girl saying, I will never grow old. In the midst of that genius, another genius was produced. This, the greatest voice that the human experience has ever internalized. This, the voice of the gospel message, coming along at a time when black people were fighting against racial injustice and white supremacy like we are today. Here we are today, 50 years later, still having to say, Black Lives Matter. We know all lives matter, that ain't the point. We say it, Black Lives Matter too. Stop killing us, stop murdering us, stop terrorizing us, stop hurting us, stop burning us, and recognize that we are children of God. Aretha Franklin came along when Dr. King was telling the truth about his dream in America. And she held several fundraisers for him. Why? Because she did not think that it was the right thing to do to be blessed with the genius that God gave her and not love her people. And so when she sang about respect, she knew what she was talking about. Aretha Franklin came along when the civil rights movement was burgeoning, and her musical virtuosity was the greatest exemplar of God's sense of excellence for African American people. And so he gave Aretha Franklin a special gift. She can make you feel the Holy Ghost in the midst of your lostness. She can make you feel the Shekinah Spirit coming down from on high when God spoke through her voice. And when Aretha sings, the heavens break open. When Aretha sings, the Spirit of God becomes real. When Aretha sings, the love of God becomes manifest and the greatness of God is celebrated. Stand on your feet for the greatest of all time, Aretha Franklin.
Oh, Hallelujah.
Let's God give God some praise now. Come on and clap those hands if you really want to give. Give God some glory in the house now.
I feel really good for you.